Oi, yuggeth, what a day I've had today. Oi. Have you ever had one of those days when reality is coming at you from all directions? And you just want to scream, enough, world, back off. Today has been that day. But I think now I can relax. I hope I can relax. Not that it's been a bad day. It's been a very good day. Just really exhausting. Just lots of people coming over, and I'm trying to plan for the H.P. Lovecraft Film Festival in Portland, Oregon, and the World Fantasy Convention, and I'm trying to proof my Centipede Press book, and but it's been a really wonderful day. I finally got my copies of my book, my new book, Weird Inhabitants of SESQUA Valley, published by Teradan Press, Teradan Works. See, I'm so tired, I can't even remember the publisher of my book. This is the book, this is one of three books that I've worked on this year. I love the cover. The cover is by Jeffrey Thomas. He's an excellent horror author of his own. And he actually wrote the introduction. I love the lettering on the, when you first open it up. I love that, because to me that looks like, it looks like lettering on a tombstone in a New England burying ground. So I'm delighted. This book is, it's set in SESQUA Valley, which is a valley I invented in, I think, 1974, as kind of, it's kind of a blend of Lovecraft's Dreamland and Dunwich, a rural town. And I based it on North Bend and Snoqualmie Valley here in the Northwest, with a Twin Peak Mountain. Of course, that mountain and that valley was later used in the 1980s by David Lynch for Twin Peaks. This new book, it's all Cthulhu Mythos fiction. And all the stories are set in SESQUA Valley. SESQUA Valley is a haunted valley of supernatural potency. And it has its singular race, a race of shadow children, beasts, quasi-human, born of SESQUA Valley's haunted shadow. And outsiders to the valley are not always welcome, but there are those certain outsiders who are called to SESQUA Valley, either by dream or by doom. It's in this book, I've wanted to experiment with setting stories in the past, in the 1920s, the era in which H.P. Lovecraft wrote his own stories. And the opening story in this book is called Some Distant Baying Sound, and it is a direct sequel to Lovecraft's The Hound, and thus it is set in the year of Lovecraft's The Hound. Another story, the title of which I have just forgotten. I can't even remember my own story title. It shows you what a day I've had today. Yuggeth. Into the Depths of dreams and madness. Here's the table of contents. And quite a few stories. I think it's about 43,000 words of fiction in this. A lot of stories are new. Into the Depths of Dreams and Madness is where I bring the painter from Pickman's Model, Richard Upman Pickman. I bring him from Boston to the Sesqua Valley, and he meets with a curious fate. He comes to paint the portrait of the beast of Sesqua Valley, the firstborn spawn of Sesqua Valley's shadow, Simon Gregory Williams. Simon is a very diabolic beast, and he is richly lunatic. Well, of course he is. He has memorized every existent edition of the Necronomicon. Now, just reading the Necronomicon will drive you crazy, but to memorize each and every edition, you know, that's going to make you bonkers for sure. So, he's my favorite character. I created him a few years ago, and I enjoy him, and he's become fairly popular with my readers. So this is my very new book, just published, Weird Inhabitants of Sesqua Valley, published by Teradan Works. You may order it on their website, and or you can go to Amazon.com and order it. It's best to order when it's a small press book. It's always preferable to order it from the publisher, I think. But it's totally Cthulhu Mythos, very, very Lovecraftian to the core. I've tried to make this book very, you know, a showcase of my obsession with the fiction of H.P. Lovecraft. I hope for those of you who have never read a book by W.H. Pugmire, this, I think, is an excellent place to start. The stories are solid. There's a consistent narrative flow. So I wrote the book over, a short period of time. It was wonderful to work with Terry of Teradan Works. She was really inspirational in getting me to write new stories, because when we first started working on this book, it was going to be just a reprint volume. But the more I got so excited, well, I got excited about it because as I was writing it, S.T. Joshi's magnificent book, The Rise and Fall of the Cthulhu Mythos, came out. And that book is so cool, and it got me really wanting to write new mythos fiction, Lovecraftian fiction. And so because of the energy I got from reading ST's book, the fiction just poured out of me, and this is the result. So those of you who have never read one of my books, this is the best place to start, I think. Because it has substance, and it really explains the mystique, the allure of Sesqua Valley. So there's my little vlog of self-promotion. I wish you all an eldritch evening. I'm gonna go take it easy. I'm gonna go get some sleep, listen to some Boy George. My soul sister, Boy George. Shalom.